this video, I'll be sharing with you 10 psychological tricks that you can use to influence people. The first psychological trick that you can use to influence people is that you can get someone to do a favor for you that is called as Benjamin Franklin. First of all, let me discuss what did Benjamin do. Legend has it that Benjamin Franklin once wanted to win over a man who didn't like him. He asked the man to lend him a rare book, and when the book was received, he thanked him graciously. As a result, the man who had never wanted to speak to him before became good friends with Franklin. To quote Franklin, "He that has once done you a kindness will be more ready to do you another than he whom you yourself have obliged." So this is very powerful. So scientists decided to test this theory and found out that those who were asked by the researcher for a personal favor rated the researcher much more favorably than the other groups did. It may seem counterintuitive, but the theory is pretty sound. If someone does a favor for you, they are likely to rationalize that you must have been worth doing the favor for and decide that therefore they must like you. That is why this trick is very effective. Another trick is that you aim high. What does this trick all about? You ask for way more than you want at first and scale it back later. This trick is sometimes known as the door in the face approach. You start by throwing a really ridiculous request at someone, a request they will most likely reject. You then come back shortly thereafter and ask for something much less ridiculous. That is the thing you actually wanted in the first place. This trick may also sound counterintuitive, but the idea behind it is that the person will feel bad for refusing your first request, even though it was unreasonable. So when you ask for something reasonable, they will feel obliged to help you out this time. So this way, this can be extremely effective. So scientists tested this principle and found that it worked extremely well as long as the same person asked for both the bigger and smaller favor, because the person feels obliged to help you the second time and not anyone else. Important trick is about names. Now, what is this trick about? Is that you should use a person's name or their title depending on the situation. Now, here Dale Carnegie, who was the author of How to Win Friends and Influence People, believed that using someone's name was incredibly important. He said that a person's name is the sweetest sound in any language for that person. Of our identity, and so hearing it validates our existence, which makes us much more inclined to feel positively about the person who validated us. But using a title or form of address can also have strong effects. according to the if principle. The idea is that if you act like a certain type of person, you will become that person. Like a self-fulfilling prophecy. To use this to influence others, you can refer to them as what you want them to be. So they will start thinking of themselves this way. This can be as simple as calling an acquaintance you want to be closer to as friend or mate whenever you see them, or referring to someone you want to work for as boss. This can come off as very corny. Okay, so this was another psychological trick. The next trick is the trick of flattery. Flattery will actually get you everywhere. This is the trick. Obvious at first, but there are some important rules to it. For starters, it is important to note that if the flattery is not seen as sincere, it is going to do more harm than good. But researchers have studied the motivations behind people's reactions to flattery and found some very important things. So to put it simply, they found that people tend to look for cognitive balance, trying to always keep their thoughts and feelings organized in a similar way. So if you flatter someone who has high self-esteem and it is seen as sincere, they will like you more as you're validating how they feel about themselves. However, if you flatter someone who has low self-esteem, there's a chance it could backfire and cause them to like you less because it interferes with how they perceive themselves. That, of course, does not mean you should demean a person of low self-esteem. Psychological habit is the habit of mirroring. They say that imitation is the greatest form of flattery. Mirroring is also known as mimicry, and it's something that some people do naturally. People with this skill are considered to be chameleons. They try to blend into their environment by copying other people's behaviors, mannerisms, or even speech patterns. However, this skill can also be used consciously and is a great way to make you more likable. So, researchers studied mimicry and found that those who had been mimicked were much more likely to act favorably toward the person who had copied them. Even more interesting was their second find that those who had someone mimic their behavior were actually nicer and more agreeable to others in general. Even those not involved in this situation. It is likely that the reason why this works is that mirroring someone's behavior makes them feel validated. Next trick is use tiredness. Ask for favors when someone is tired. When someone is tired, they are more susceptible to everything someone may say, whether it is a statement or request. The reason for this is that when people are tired, it isn't just their physical body, their mental energy levels drop as well. So when you ask a request of someone who is tired, you probably won't get a definite response. But probably, and I'll do it tomorrow, because they don't want to deal with decisions at the moment. The next day, they are likely to follow through because people tend to keep their word. It's natural psychologically to want to follow through with something you said you would do. Another important psychological trick is that is the offer they can't refuse. Start with a request they can't refuse and work your way up. The reverse of the door in the face technique. Instead of starting with a large request, you start with something really small. Once it's committed to helping you or agreeing to something, they're now more likely to agree to a bigger request. So scientists tested this phenomenon in regards to marketing. They started by getting people to express support for the rainforest and the environment, which is fairly a simple request. Then they found that once they had gotten them to express their agreement to supporting the environment, they were much easier to convince when it came to buying products that supported rainforest and other such things. However, don't start with one request and immediately assail them with another. Psychologists found it much more effective if you wait a day or two to make the second request. So this is how it's going to work for you. The next technique, psychological technique for getting what you want, is to keep quiet. What is the trick here? Don't correct people when they are wrong. So here Dale Carnegie also pointed out in his famous book that telling someone they are wrong is usually unnecessary and does the opposite of endearing them to you. There is actually a way to show disagreement and turn it into a polite conversation without telling someone they are wrong, which strikes to the core of their ego.